you. I'm Golden Misabiko. I'm a leader of a civil society in the Congo. And I always work through transparency, I work for human rights and good governance. This country is one of the richest countries in the world as far as potential is concerned. You have copper, you have gold, you have cobalt, you have cassiterite, you have all those minerals that are needed on the markets. Congo is again being kind of colonized. This time they come like investors, but in the way they are cheating because the Congolese are suffering from lack of a technology, of expertise. So there are many countries, many companies who come to Congo. Oh, they sign the contract that they are coming for copper, but they take gold, they take germanium. Some even take the land, the soil. Every day, thousands and thousands of trucks are going to South Africa with minerals. How can Congo be the poorest country in the world? Mm-hmm. I think Congo should have a fair place to say that it is developing other countries. Chinese, they come to Congo. How can Congo occupy a humiliating place? Namely, Colombo Tantali. These minerals can only be found in the Congo. Or I can say that 70% of this mineral called Colombo Tantali, which is a Coltan, is used in all the telephones in this machine you are using. Most of the things that is in there is from Congo. So when you travel all over the world, you see a person with a telephone or such a machine, or in the planes that are flying in the sky, most of the equipment are made of Colombo Tantali, the Coltan, from Congo. That is developing other countries, starting with South Africa. I'm talking about India. I'm talking about Europe. I can name names of countries. They are getting all what they need from Congo. Indians are that many are coming to Congo to develop, to do business and develop their economy.
Can you give some name of the Indian company?
The company called Shemaf. CHEMAF stands for Chemical of Africa. They came, the first contract that they signed to come to Congo and make the medical products. But they changed it into mining. And they did not want to go out of the city. They made a plant, mining processing unit, at about 200 meters, even 150 meters from a school, for children's school. A terrible smell of chemicals, of acids, and all the walls of the houses and that area is being attacked by the acids. One of the mining trucks hit a child, and that child had to be amputated. The child was coming from school. I told you that it's the school area. That child was almost abandoned in the hospital. And I went there to negotiate, to say, well, this child was hit by your truck. It's a simple thing. You just see how you can do to compensation. It took almost 2 years or 3 years. And still, they were refusing to cover the pain of that child. The other company called Somika is a joint venture between an Indian and a Canadian. Somika stands for Société Minière du Katanga, which stands a mining company of Katanga. It's located on a higher level. According to the Lubumbashi Water Supply Authority, they say that that place is where the underground water of Lubumbashi, a mining company on that area, is to pollute and to ruin that reserve to give water to over 2 million people in Lubumbashi.
We Indian feel that we were colonized by the British. We have the same kind of humiliation. How you feel about the Indians?
The Indians who came to Africa, who came to Congo, who come to Congo, even the Indians who were in Zambia, and the Indians who were in South Africa, who came because of the change of regimes, and when they come to Congo, they behave differently. They behave like Belgians. They behave like British people. Mm-hmm. There is a total separation between development system in and yet we have many Indians there, but there is a kind of a racism. They don't go with us. Mm-hmm. They sell things or they buy things. That's all. We can't start a nation with Indians in Congo. There is a separation. Mm-hmm. Mahatma Gandhi was an African-minded person, and in the history we were sharing the same pain as a people who are oppressed. Indians need to be questioning how their nationals in other countries are behaving. I don't hate them, but they need to behave, because how can you implement a mining company in a city? This is what I'm telling you to the parliaments in South Africa. How your interests are behaving in Congo? Are your interests ruining our people in Congo? But at the same time, that international companies that are stealing all minerals and they take it home in their countries and they leave the country without anything. They don't build the roads, they don't build the schools, they don't build anything. They're just coming there to plunder, to take all the minerals, take it home. It's shocking that in the exploitation of our natural resources, they commit crimes for them to get our minerals, to get our Colombo tantalite and the other cassette and the other minerals. They have to create a war in order to chase local population on their natural areas. They fight them, they chase them, they rape women, they create panic, they humiliate husbands and children, and they run away. They won't come back to their wives again because their wives were raped. They destroy all area where they locate this Colombo tantalite because the market is demanding this Colombo tantalite. The world is unfair, and the world is cheating this country. Over 9 million people killed because of this system they've created of killing people, chasing people, and getting Colombo tantalite cheap and sell them to Europe, sell it to America, sell Colombo tantalite to Asia. Once you heard me speak with a broken heart, I'm saying things clearly that this is unfair, this is unjust, this needs to stop, and this needs to be brought to international courts.